One of the most important steps you can take to reduce the risk of contaminating your fruits and vegetables is washing your hands. Wash your hands several times a day on the farm, before and after harvesting produce, after handling manure or animals, after eating, using the restroom, smoking, touching your face, coughing, sneezing, or any other time you think your hands have come into contact with germs. This will be easier to do if you have convenient hand washing stations placed near all restrooms, packing sheds, or any area where workers are handling produce. Here are the tools and materials you'll need to build your hand washing stand. For lumber, you'll need two long 2x6 boards, one long 2x4 board, and a sheet of plywood that is 1/2 inches thick. Your tools will include a saw, a drill and drill bits, a package of 2.5-inch deck screws, a tape measure and measuring square, and a pencil. You'll need gloves and protection for your ears and eyes. You'll need a water container with a spigot that can be turned on and off, hand soap, a dish pan to hold paper towels, a 5-gallon bucket to catch the wash water, and another 5-gallon bucket for used paper towels. First, you will cut the 2x6-inch board into 4 pieces that are 36 inches long to make the 4 legs of the hand washing stand. Use a tape measure and square to mark 36 inches on the boards and cut 4 of them. Step 2. Now you will cut and attach the 4 leg connectors. The length of these pieces will be determined by the length of your dish pan. In this scenario, we are using a 12-quart dish pan that is about 15 inches long, 12 inches wide, and 6 inches high. Because our dish pan is 15 inches long, we will cut our leg connectors to 15 inches long. Use a tape measure to mark the 2x4 board before you cut it. The top leg connector should be placed 1.5 inches below the top of the legs. This will allow enough space to create a lip for your dishpan drawer to slide on. This distance could vary depending on the height of your dishpan's handle. Use a tape measure and pencil to mark 1.5 inches from the top of the legs. This is where you will attach your top leg connectors. Check to see that the location of the leg connector allows the dishpan to slide back and forth. While holding the leg connector firmly in place, drill 2 holes at one end. Then attach it to the top of the first leg with your deck screws. Now move over to the second leg and repeat the process to attach the other end of the top leg connector to the second leg. Moving on to the bottom leg connectors. The precise location of the bottom connectors is not so crucial, but you may still want to mark a location about 1 inch or 2 from the bottom of the leg, just to give it stability and a uniform appearance. Once the first 2 leg pieces are connected, follow the same process to connect the second 2 leg pieces. Now that you have 2 sets of connected leg pieces, it's time to cut and attach your 4 cross pieces. The length of the cross pieces depends on the width of the dishpan. Stand the leg pieces up and set the dishpan on the leg connectors. The pan should fit snugly but still slide in and out easily. Measure the length between the legs. That will be the length of your cross pieces. Measure and cut the remainder of your 2x4 board into 4 cross pieces. First, you will attach the bottom cross pieces to the legs. Mark drill hole locations 3/4 inch from the end of the cross piece. Drill 2 holes, then do the same on the other end of the piece. Attach the screws just part way. Hold hold the end of the crosspiece to the top edge of the bottom connector and finish driving in the screws. Now you can stand both sets of legs upright and finish screwing the other ends of the bottom crosspieces to the top edges of the connectors. Now it's time to attach the top cross pieces. Set your dish pan in place, check the width of your top cross pieces, and mark the legs to show where the top cross pieces should go. They should be low enough so the dish pan fits in the space above. Tip the stand back over on its side and hold one piece in place. Mark two drill hole locations 3/4 inch from the edge to make sure the screws will go through the leg into the middle of the crosspiece. Drill the holes and screw the crosspiece in place. Turn the stand over and drill and screw the other end of the crosspiece into the leg. Flip the stand over again and attach the second crosspiece in the same way. Stand the hand washing stand upright. You're almost done. Step 4. Now you will cut and install the plywood top. Measure the top of your stand to determine the size of the plywood top. Allow for a 1/2 inch overhang on all 4 sides. Cut the plywood to fit your stand and screw it into place. Now that your stand is built, you can install the dishpan drawer to hold your paper towels and the water container. Place a bucket underneath a spigot to catch the water. Keep a lidded trash can handy for used paper towels. Fill the water container with clean water, and don't forget the soap. This hand washing stand makes it easy for everyone on your farm to wash their hands regularly. To learn more and to download step-by-step instructions, please visit the links in the video description.